a world that's in a grave state of moral decay. You can't pick up a newspaper, turn on the radio, turn on the TV, turn on the internet. You can't do any of that stuff without worldly moral decay being full. I read the other day, they're going to release that lady that killed the preacher. She's coming to your church next Sunday. They called and asked what would a good church. I told them, Mom, that's that. And I don't know if you read that article or not, but one of the members of the church, they asked him if she would be welcome. And he pretty much said no. And she wouldn't be because he wouldn't forgive her. I want to tell you something. You want to know why people don't want to walk through those doors in our churches? Because, see, the world has chewed them up and spit them out. The world has judged them on what they look like and how much money they've got in the bank and whether or not they smell good when they come to church. The world's put all these stipulations on them about degrees and this and that. And they've said, you're not good enough, and we're not going to take you if you don't meet our standards. Aren't you glad that the blood of Jesus can save a wretch like me and you? You see, those people that come through those doors are hurting, they're seeking, and they need to know that the place that they can come and be loved and accepted just as they are is in God's house. But revival has to start in us. I want to close with this. We'll get ready to do the invitation. The last part of verse 14 says this. Then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. God's response to our revival is threefold. He says, then will I hear from heaven. When you and I allow God to revive us every day, we get the divine visitation. Oh, have you not been at the bedside of somebody or stood outside the window in that baby boy and you prayed and you felt the divine presence of Almighty God and His Spirit right there? You knew that you were not alone. God says, when we hunger, when we pray, when we seek, and when we turn, then He will hear from heaven. The second thing He tells us is that, and then I will forgive their sins. Forgiveness. He'll hear, and He'll forgive. He'll hear, and He'll forgive. Without Jesus, I would be nothing. Without Jesus, all would be lost. But He heard. And He forgave. And the last thing He says is, I'll send a healing revival. I'll make new that which is dead. How? And I will heal the land. Heal. Heal. In your heart tonight. If there's something going on and the devil's got a hold of you, he wants to keep you stuck in that pew. He wants to keep you chained and bound. The last thing that Satan wants tonight is for there to be revival in your life. For there to be revival in this church. For there to be new families brought in and new lives changed because of the power of the blood of Jesus. But you and I need to ask Him to visit us again, to forgive us again, and to heal us one more time again. We're going to sing a hymn of invitation. And if you're in need, something in your life. prayer, healing. I'll tell you what, you go up there, and I know two boys that will just pray with you till the cows come home. Don't you leave here bound and dead. Don't you leave here stuck where the devil's got you. You see, I thought on the way in, Lord, what if this is the last time I have a chance to speak to these people of yours at Mount Pleasant? Lord, what if I never have another opportunity to talk about revival through Jesus? Lord, you give me the words. And it's simple. God says, if my people seek and pray, humble themselves on their knees and turn, I will heal them. You need that tonight. You come on as we sit.